Previously, we explored the simple setup of installing WAN 2.1 for generating AI videos. With a bit more complexity in using Comfy UI, we can achieve better performance in generating the same AI videos. In this video, I will set up Comfy UI for AI video generation. If you have already installed Comfy UI, please check the timestamps for the WAN 2.1 AI video generator. To begin, I will go to the search bar and type Comfy UI. I can download it from the first result. Even the second result will provide a Windows installer, but I will choose the first option. Scroll down, and you should see the installation section for the Windows portable version. Click this direct link to download, and the download should begin. The file size is approximately 1.6 gigabytes. Once it's downloaded, extract the file by clicking Extract All, or you can use WinRAR. I will extract it to the desktop, but make sure to extract it to a drive with at least 50 gigabytes of free space. The more AI models you download, the more space Comfy UI will require. This is the file after extraction. When I open the folder, I see several files. The last two files will run Comfy UI. The first one uses the CPU for processing, which is approximately 40 to 50 times slower than using a GPU. Since I have an NVIDIA GPU, I will use the second file. Once the program starts running, the output is displayed in the command prompt. Now, the Comfy UI is visible in the browser, but it indicates that a checkpoint is missing. This checkpoint is the AI model we need to download, as it will be used by Comfy UI to generate images. I will click Download and select the file location inside the Comfy UI, specifically in the Models and Checkpoint folder. After the download is complete, I will click the Queue button to test if everything works. Yes, it is generating images. There may be a scenario where you need to click on this checkpoint, and then you will see a drop-down menu. Just click the checkpoint's name in the drop-down, and it should work. Next, I will get the video generator for Comfy UI. I will be using Kijai's wrapper, which is an efficient and practical option for beginners. If you scroll down, you will see the Comfy UI wrapper for WAN Video. There are two steps for installation. First, we need to install these nodes, and then the dependencies. To install the nodes, I will go to the Custom Node folder. To clone these nodes, I need to install Git for Windows. I will search for it, and from the first result, I will click to download. It's a small file, so after downloading, I will install it quickly. The installation is straightforward. I just need to click Next. Now, in the Custom Node folder, I will click here, type CMD, and press Enter. This opens the command prompt in the folder. I want to verify if Git is installed properly. To do this, I will type git-v. I made a mistake. It should be a lowercase v, and it will respond with the installed version. Next, I will scroll up and copy the clone link. In the same folder, I will use the git clone command to clone the project using the copied link. It's done. Everything has been cloned into this new folder. The second step is to install the requirements. We should not use the pip command because, in this video, we downloaded the portable folder. Instead, I will use the command below. I will go to the Comfy UI Windows portable folder. Close the previous custom node command prompt and open a new one here. Then I will copy and paste the command and press Enter. Now I have comfy UI and the custom nodes for AI videos, but these nodes are confusing, and to manage them, I need a manager. I search for the comfy UI manager, which will help manage all the nodes. The installation instructions say to go to the custom nodes and clone the manager. I am in the folder, so I will open the command prompt, copy and paste the command, and then press enter. It says to restart the Comfy UI, so I will close the CMD window open by Comfy UI and run it again. Now I have the manager to manage Comfy UI in the notes. The QGI wrapper for 1.2.1 states that we need to have these AI models to generate the AI videos. If you remember, at the beginning, when I installed Comfy UI, I had the option to download the AI model when the interface was loaded. I believe I should get the same download model option again. I will scroll to the top to find a workflow. These are some workflows for generating AI videos, similar to what we saw before for generating an image. Let me open this workflow. There is a copy button to copy the workflow. Back in Comfy UI, I will press Ctrl plus V to paste it. However, there are some missing nodes. This red node indicates a missing component, but I have downloaded the manager to handle such situations. The second option in the manager is about installing missing nodes, so I will click Install and then select the latest version. Now it says to restart Comfy UI. After restarting and reloading, the red highlight is gone. I will try to generate a video with the default values, but I see an error. The error is due to missing models. I did not get the option to download automatically, which could have simplified the process for viewers. Now we have to download these three files manually. I will match the text encoder name and look for the corresponding file here. Download it and place it inside the models and then the text encoder folder. The second file is the diffuser file. I will press Ctrl plus F and paste the name. This file is around 15 gigabytes, and I will save it into the models and then the diffusion models folder. The third file is the VAE, which is a small file that goes inside the models and then the VAE folder. After downloading, I tried generating a video, but got an error. Two of these files were not picked up. This node automatically retrieved the file from the text encoder folder, but the other two nodes did not. I need to select the files manually. So, this node needs the diffusion model, and the VAE file will be for this node. I tried again, and the process started successfully. The Pinocchio installation did not utilize the entire VRAM, but this custom node is using the GPU fully. After 24 minutes, I received the result, which looks good to me. I like the outcome. What do you think? The height and width can be adjusted from here, and the total number of frames is 81. At a rate of 16 frames per second, this results in a 5-second video. The prompt used here was the default, but you can change it for a different video. The number of steps is set to 25, which works well within the range of 25 to 30 steps. The default values are optimal, unless you're using some LoRa. Next, I will try this image to video workflow. Copy the workflow. Open a new tab and paste. So it automatically opens a new tab here. The prompt here is about an old man stroking his beard thoughtfully. On the left, we can upload the image. I searched for the old man's photos and found this image, and I uploaded the image. With all the default settings, I tried running the process and got the error for the missing files. The model files are different for image to video processes. These are the three nodes giving error for the files. I will search the file as did before. Download and save it into text encoder folder. The VAE file should already exist because I downloaded the file in the previous text to video example. I still checked. And it says it already exists. The last file is the image to video model. And it's a 17 gigabyte file. Keep it into the diffusion model folder. After download, I will select this file for video clip encoder, large VIT, huge file. Then the VAE, which already exists. Make sure you have this UML5 for the T5 text encoder I downloaded in the previous text to video process. Just a note, if you have a low memory error, if it says load on device something like that, try changing this to FP8 from BF16. This is the FP8 file. And last is the image to video model. So I think that should be all needed here. And the generation process started. After 25 minutes, I got the result, and as expected, the result is good. The challenge here was generating the hand with motion because it wasn't present in the image, and the hand generated is good. The softness of hair is close to real. What do you think? Comfy UI is definitely better than the Pinocchio setup I did in the previous video.